Hi friends, myself Sanjesh Patil, and today we are going to discuss environmental assessment. Now the content of these presentations are environmental impact assessment, that is EIA definition, then objectives of EIA, then first environmental legislation, then EIA methodology, how EIA is carried out, then the actual EIA process, and last is methods of impact identification. Now let us see one by one. First of all, definition of EIA, that is environmental impact assessment. Now it can be defined as an activity designed to identify the impact on the biogeophysical environment means combination of biological, geological and physical environment on man, and well-being of legislative proposals, then projects, policies, operational procedure, and to interpret and communicate information. Okay, so now impact of biogeophysical environment on man related with project, then policies and operational procedures, that is called as environmental impact assessment. Then EIA is a effective process of identifying future consequences of a current or proposed action, how we are going to see in next slide. Then objectives of EIA, first to identify or to predict and evaluate the economic, environmental and social impact of development activities. Now suppose we have to start some industry or we have to start with some development activities. So first of all, we have to study what are its consequences on the environmental issues, what the development project will affect, or how the development project will affect the environmental issues, that we have to study. The next objective is to provide information on the environmental consequences for decision making. So after finding the impact on environmental issues, then we have to take some decisions regarding the environmental consequences of the particular project. Then to promote environmentally sound and sustainable development through the identification of appropriate alternatives and mitigation measures. So ultimately we have to achieve sustainable development. So for that purpose, EIA is used. Now mitigation measures means to prevent the environment affecting issues. So we have to take certain corrective actions. So it will prevent the effect of environmental issues. Then EIA is widely accepted as a tool to measure sustained development with minimum environmental degradation. That is our ultimate aim, because we have to carry out the sustainable development with minimum environmental degradation. For this purpose, EIA is used. Now, first environmental legislation. So this is related with NEPA, that is National Environmental Policy Act. Okay, and this we have discussed in our previous presentation. So just this slide will give brief information how or when this NEPA was implemented, different versions are added, and finally it is amended and implemented on 4th May 1994, right? Now EIA methodology. So whenever a new development project is planned which is likely to affect environment quality, it is necessary to carry out EIA. Now for that sake, the first step is in EIA method, is to determine whether the project under consideration follows the jurisdiction of the relevant acts and regulation, and if so, whenever it is likely to create a significant environmental disruption. So, the project should follow certain rules that are made. It should follow the rules and regulations that are made by the government, right? So, there will be minimum environmental disruption. If so, an EIA is undertaken and the environmental impact statement is prepared. So, another step is, depending upon the EIA, we have to prepare environmental impact statement, that is EIS. Then, next step is, in many countries, EIS is open to public scrutiny and it is reviewed at public hearing. So, the society or the public should know what is the impact of the project on environment. So, it is made public, the scrutiny is made public and the hearing is public, so that everybody has the right to understand what are the consequences on environment. And finally, a political decision is taken. The development project may be either accepted or accepted with amendments, or the alternative proposer is accepted or rejected. So, these are the four outcomes of the project, whether it has to be accepted, it has to be accepted with amendments, or it has some alternative proposal that has to be done, or the project is scrapped or project is rejected. So, depending upon all these things, finally we will come to a decision. Next, environment impact assessment process. So, it is a 8 guideline process how the environmental impact assessment should be done. So, the first step is participation, and appropriate and timely access to the process for all interested parties, that is, participation of all interested parties should be there during the assessment. Second is transparency. All assessment decisions and their basis should be open and accessible. So, there should be a transparency in the whole process. So, everybody can have the knowledge of what is going on. Third, certainty. The process and the timing of the assessment should be agreed by all participants in advance. Fourth, accountability. So, the decision makers of all the parties are responsible for their action and decision under the assessment process. So, there should be accountability for the decision makers. So, next step is credibility. Assessment is undertaken with professionalism and objectivity. So, the realistic things has to be considered. Sixth step is cost effectiveness. The assessment process and its outcomes will ensure environmental protection at the least cost to the society. So, there should not be any burden for the environmental protection on the society. Next step is flexibility. The assessment process should be able to deal efficiently with any proposal and decision making situation. So, it should offer flexibility. And last step is practicality. The information and outputs provided by the assessment process are readily usable in decision making and planning. Okay. So, these are the 8 steps that has to be carried out in EIA. Next step is methods of impact identification. So, now there are 4 methods used to find out the impact. We have to find out the impact. So, the 4 methods used are, in fact, I have written 5, but there are 4 methods. First is checklist, then second is matrices, third is network, and last is map overlay. So these are the four methods. So in the next presentation, we are going to see in detail these four methods. Okay, so here we will stop, and in next presentation we will see in detail the description of this impact identification methods. Thank you.